guys, it's Dandelion Song here, and I wanted to bring you back and let's talk more about Washington, D.C. Awkward close-up there of, I think that's Osiris, but I'm still questioning that this is Horus, and there is a Horus Senior and a Horus Junior, and I have a lot to learn about Egyptian mythology. I just got a book in the mail, and learning as we go, but I'll show you why I think that this is Horus. Let me just bring this up here. And I did do a time lapse, so I'm going to put that in this video. But let me show you some of the controversies that I'm working on. But if we zoom in over here on Horus. Oh, I hope I didn't move it. Let me make sure I didn't move the whole thing. Did I? I think it's still okay. I'm going to draw this out in the time lapse, but I just want to show you before we get that to that point so that you understand why I have Horus here. And I would like to, I am going to do an overlay of Osiris here. One thing that makes me think it's Osiris is that it's a coffin. See how it's not a human shape like over here. Isis has her shoulders and her neck and she's not in a coffin. Oh, I did move this. Here, hold on. I'm sorry. Let's see here. Let's put him back where he belongs. See, the eyes match right up there. And I think all the rest of it is still okay. One thing that I noticed when I did this is that it happens to match. This is the only, well, there's probably other images of Horus facing forward, but they're not that easy to find. Usually they are in profile. And one thing I noticed is that he has his hand kind of at the same, I wondered if they had were aware of this when they made this construction, because his elbow and this arm of Virginia Avenue kind of lines up. So the other thing I wanted to tell you now that I have him back in place was that look here on his left side, and there is something that could be a scorpion. And there is a scorpion, of course, in the tale of Horus. He was bit by a scorpion and brought back to life by Thoth. And there will be a better drawing of this when you go through the time lapse. The time lapse is coming up. So I just want to kind of outline this for you to use just so that you can see where this kind of lays on the Horus drawing, because when I do it in the time lapse, I don't have the Horus overlay. The thing that makes me think that this is Osiris is one is that Osiris is the one missing the phallus. Osiris is the husband of Isis, so all of that makes sense. And he might have the same kind of features on his face, but also that this is more of a coffin shape. See, if you look around this outside shape, it doesn't really conform to his body. So that is the sign of that this is Osiris. And, you know, I really do think it's Osiris. I just didn't find a picture of Osiris that matches. And then I was confused here by the Scorpio. You know, maybe he's just going to, you know, have a lobster feed. Maybe they're going to eat later and they just need a lobster for when they eat later. Or not. I don't know. Well, I think you're going to like this one. There's so much to see here, but one of the quick things I wanted to point out is that he is 2.02 mile tall. And I put his feet here on 3rd Avenue. So in the way the statue is, his toe is going to come over, but this is the height that I took is from 3rd Avenue up to the top of his head, and it is 2.02 right to here. The other thing I noticed about this is that this is a little, look at this shape into the water. It does look a little like the crowns that they had. Not so much the one that he's wearing right now, but the crowns that they had. Also, one thing, you know, I saw a cobra on the forehead of the Horus child in Paris. I really don't see a cobra on the forehead unless it's coming this way, so I didn't draw that in. So I need to go and look and see if Osiris has a cobra on his forehead. But I do want to show you that the rest of the monument type of the height of this fits with all of the anatomy here. And then I'll just look at this side before we go to the time lapse, just so that you can see Isis right here. Now, if you drew her by herself, in the time lapse, I drew them both together. But if you drew her by herself, her legs would go off in this direction. And the classic drawing of her with her arms out and the wings spread has her knees going off. I believe it, her knees actually go off to this direction. And that's another of my questions about these drawings that I find on the ground, is I find that they are a mirror image of the classic position. So yet again, we see that here. So I want to mention that. But so she would, I didn't find her knees coming this direction towards the Capitol, which is right here. So this is where the Pope's coming, is the White House right here. Now I don't have the days handy in my mind, but I think it is the 23rd here. I think it's the 24th here at the Capitol, in which case I just want to show you. I think they said he will be speaking outdoors, and I wanted to show you this 33 degrees from here to from this inside to this inside is 33 degrees. And I've talked about this eye before. I've talked about the two eyes, this eye facing this way and the other eye on facing the other way on the, from the Washington Monument. So if you are interested in that, you can check out that video. So he'll be facing this way, and this is the 269th degree heading. And goes right through here, right through his belly button, I guess you could say, through the Lincoln Memorial. And if you follow that all the way out, keeps going. And I followed it all the way to the Mexican border, where I laid that down precisely. And there was a 911 number in that. There was a 91 and a 19 mirror and a 911 number in that full distance. And the 269 heading, I believe, is connected somehow to September. For example, I don't know if I want to say that off the top of my head. I might say it wrong, but I believe, should I try and go on my memory here? From my memory, and this might not be right, I'll hopefully catch it in an edit if it's not right, but I believe that that September 26th is the 269th day of the year. And that, I think, is the day that the Pope is addressing the UN. 266. Yeah, so, yeah, because the two, yeah, because that's 3 days after. That does make sense. Okay, so I hope that I got that right. All right, well, you guys, all right, stay tuned for the time lapse. We'll be right back. All right. Well, I hope you like that. There's a lot more to see here. I want to talk about the coincidence of if this is Osiris, that's king of the underworld. He was forced into the underworld by Set. Doesn't mean that he's the Dark Lord just because he's in the underworld. Set killed him, so Set could be the Dark Lord. I'm confused too. But what I noticed here is that if this was like a cartoon, and Arlington Cemetery would be a thought box. And I've done some of the distances and some of the headings between the Lincoln Center here, which is, I would say, the center of the head of let's just call him Osiris for now, and the construction into Arlington. So there are more videos that need to be done. You know, there's so many things to see. There's so many distances. I was really surprised when I was here how important, wait, what happened to my life? Oh, there it is. How important the Jefferson Monument is. You know, it's really right in there with the lineups. Okay, well, thanks for watching. I'm going to bring more to you. I am going to be finding more things in Google Earth. I've been trying to catch up on some of the symbolism and educate myself so that I know more about what I'm seeing. I would like to be able to say more about the things that I find. So I'm trying to keep up with the research as well as taking a look at Google Earth and bringing more things to light here. I hope everybody had a safe 8/16, and I hope that went well. I actually haven't checked the news. All right, guys. Well, love you guys. Hope you're having a good day. Talk to you later. Bye-bye.